Hey guys, I'm coming to you from Power by the Hour, and yeah, I know, I haven't shaved in like a week and a half, so I look like a caveman. Forget about that. Today we're talking fuel systems. Now, we get a lot of questions regarding how to set up a fuel system on Coyote swap cars, supercharged and turbocharged Coyotes, and I have the Fairmont on the dyno after a fuel pump change, and I thought it'd be a good idea to bring you sort of like a mini tutorial, not a tutorial, more what to look out for when it comes to setting up a fuel system. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the fuel system on this car, and it's going to translate to Coyote swaps, especially supercharged Coyote swaps and supercharged Coyote equipped vehicles 11 through 19. So let's take a look at what's going on, why I'm on the dyno at Power by the Hour with the Fairmont, and why am I monitoring fuel pressure. As you can see, I have the car here on the Power by the Hour dyno, and I have a GoPro set up facing down on the fuel pressure gauge. Now, this car has a return style fuel system with the Four Innovations regulator, and it is boost reference, meaning it is grabbing a boost reference from the supercharger, which is also activating the bypass. Theoretically, the fuel pressure should rise with boost. Now, how do you set up your fuel system? Well, this is what we tell people. Key on, engine off. We like it to be at 55 PSI. So let me key on and show you what it reads. Let's just walk over, flip the switch on this guy, and you'll hear the fuel pump. You should be able to hear the fuel pump activate. Perfect. Let's go see what it reads on the gauge. Absolutely nothing. Let's turn the car on, and then we'll basically do it by pulling the boost reference line and do it that way. It's lovely. Things in park? Yes, sir. Let's go. All right. All right, so with the boost reference on, it should drop to slightly under 45, and the way you test that is you pull the boost reference right off and you make sure you cap it. That's just gonna kill the car. Okay, engine running, boost line removed. It is about actually right at 55 PSI. Obviously I'm capping the line, and as you can see, there is vacuum basically going to it. So when you set it at 55 and you reinstall the boost reference line, it should drop to about 43 PSI or so. Okay, perfect. So that's how we want you to set up a fuel system on every Coyote vehicle that is supercharged, meaning key on, engine off, or engine running, no boost reference, 55 PSI. Once you put the boost reference on the regulator, it should drop to about 43 or 45 PSI as it sits. Now what I'm gonna do is take this GoPro and record the car at wide open throttle. I'm not gonna lock it in gear and do a full pull. What I'm gonna do is roll into it in second gear and then record it with this guy and look back at the footage and see if fuel pressure starts to rise with RPM and boost, because this will go from vacuum to boost once that bypass shuts and it starts making boost at the supercharger. So I'm gonna do that real quick and see what the footage says, because I want to confirm that the new fuel pump that I put in the guy is keeping up with the fuel demands of about a 900 or so rear wheel horsepower setup. Hopefully that's a good enough shot for you guys. Sure, what the hell. Set up the GoPro.
Thank you.
Okay, so there you have it. Mission accomplished, really. Something that I needed to verify along the way, and something that shops, and if you're putting a car together on your end and having it remote tuned, you should monitor. Certain things we can monitor in the data log, certain things we cannot. 11 to 17 Mustangs do not have a fuel rail pressure monitor. So you either have to analog it in or do it old school and video it like I did. 18 and up Mustangs and every GT500 on the planet does monitor fuel pressure, and it modulates pulse width based on fuel pressure. So be mindful of that. Every GT500 has a fuel rail pressure sensor. Not many Coyote GTs do until 2018, none at all actually. So that's something you have to analog in and have your tuner maybe send you a configuration for that. Or if you have a ZT2 box with an N-gauge, you can analog it right in. There's fuel rail pressure, there's boost, then there's AFR actually on the ZT2 box from Zaytronics. So this was nice to verify fuel pressure. It's getting plenty of fuel. The car's ready for Texas 2K. There's not much else I need to do to it. Fuel pump's intact. I got to mess with the wiring, clean up the wiring back there with the continuous duty solenoid that I installed. And that's pretty much it. Goals for Texas 2K is 850s. I might have to install a parachute, but man, that's $1,000. So we'll see what happens. You'll see if I put one on Texas 2K or not. But I'm going to try to get some testing in before Texas 2K, do two track events, at least two, figure out the 60-foot eighth mile, and see if I can stop this car before I go into the sand trap. Thanks for listening, guys. This was a nice, quick, and easy, dirty video about fuel pressure on Coyote Mustangs, how to monitor it, and how to know if you have enough fuel for your setup. Thanks for listening, guys. We'll talk to you later.